You at home, if you've ever made a video and gotten into making graphics or some kind of animation for that, you know there's no one program that does everything. That's why we have After Effects and Photoshop and Illustrator and Cinema 4D. I do this professionally. I'm a motion graphics animator and I've been waiting for a program that does 2D and 3D with a design and animation focus. And I think that program might be here. In this video, I'm going to tell you about Project Avalanche, and I'm going to outline, I think, 10 things about it that I'm very excited about. And here they are. It combines 2D and 3D in real time. I feel like that sentence is a bit too short to communicate just how big of a thing that is, but every single program that does that is After Effects. They've made gains, but it's not real time. Premiere, even. Gains, but... you know, you add any graphic, not real time. In terms of 2D design, it does a lot more than I expected. There are elements of Photoshop's layer system. You have rulers and guides. You can design shapes really quickly. You can bring in vectors. And because we're in Unreal, all of those can be extruded and immediately they're in the 3D environment. So number three, the 3D actually looks good. This is what made me use Unreal in the first place. Even before I was interested in the motion graphics aspects of it. Of all of the real-time rendering solutions that the studio that I was at the time looked at, Unreal was the only one that looked good. All of the real-time shadows were really, really soft and nice. The material system was fully featured. It was, it had a particle system that was also running real-time. It was a very fully featured system, you know, years ago. Nowadays, Nanite, Lumen, and all of the amazing progress that the Unreal team have made on the graphical side, it's available to you in Avalanche. Four, I know I'm harping on this, the 3D not only looks good, but the way you can manipulate it in real time is stuff that we haven't seen anywhere at this kind of speed. Real time manipulators like booleans and effectors, even Niagara particles, all happening together at the same time in viewport. Just a reminder, Niagara is so powerful, it can do fluid simulations. Actually, let me go a bit longer on those effectors. They can be texture controlled, they can have forces like gravity or noise, they can have programmatic additions, and harness a lot of the more powerful features of Unreal. This is a crazy feature to have access to. I could go on for a while. Six, this may be not exciting to people who aren't in Unreal, but now you can browse system fonts just this easily. I would have liked to see some more examples of maybe kerning and per letter kerning, but it's a really good start, especially when they showed how you can animate them like After Effects text animators. They have wiggle and bounce. I hadn't realized how attached I had been to After Effects text animators until I saw that. Very exciting. Another thing I'm super excited about is that it goes further than design. The best thing about being real time is that it is a real time stage and queuing system for motion graphics. This is the stuff that I was saying had only been available to television stations and big live events. It's now accessible to anyone. You can set up complex transition logic. You can set up full state trees for what's going to happen when something else happens. You can link these all to real-time data sources. On that note, if you want to get super technical, you can actually procedurally generate full animations from data. Here's this animation of potential hurricane paths that is coming from an Excel spreadsheet. So the roadmap says that the experimental release will be part of 5.4 in quarter one of 2024, fingers crossed. I'll keep you updated with whatever info I find online. Today's Unreal Fest talk has energized me once again. Cheers.